welders are needed for critical weld surfaces in a vehicle, in different components. So do you really want your skilled labor welding fasteners? I think it's a poor use of their skills. So we have been working with customers to convert from weld fasteners to rivet nut fasteners. And here is one of the tools that we use with our customer base. So this is an analysis where we will take an application and evaluate three different solutions: the current weld fastener that they may be using, a clinching solution, and a rivet nut solution. Now, different levels of automation may change these times, but for the most part, welding is a slower process. Clinching and riveting are faster solutions. If we expand this lowest total installed cost model to include various piece prices and processing costs, you'll notice on the top line something that prohibits this change at times. And that is, if you look at a bill of material, you may find that a weld nut is inexpensive. It is an inexpensive manufacturing process to make welded fasteners. Clinching and riveting solutions can be double the cost, sometimes triple the cost. However, when you take into account the skilled labor requirements for welding, when you take into account the energy costs of welding, the consumable costs of welding, welding fasteners can be double to triple the cost of comparable clinching and riveting solutions. That's just three components of the cost workup. Okay? If you include the cost for thread masking, the cost for the additional labor that may have to deal with quality issues, weld fasteners coming loose, the repair costs for those failures, the labor shortages, shop floor allocation, right? Welding equipment usually takes up more floor space. So if we can take that floor space and dedicate it to revenue generating solutions and not a costly process like welding, there's a tremendous amount of savings to be had.